about your plans, but just turn it off, okay? So we don't have any bells going up, that would be appreciated. So welcome. This is the Acting Lab's third show. First year we did A Few Good Men, and we found out that some people could handle the truth. Remember that line? Second show, The Odd Couple. I don't mean odd like this. It's a different kind of odd. You saw those guys last year, Oscar and Felix. So anyway, this year we're going to do Mr. Robert. It's a play by two gentlemen, Thomas Heggen and Joshua Logan. And just to show you the kind of shows we're putting on for you, this play won the Pulitzer Prize in 1948. So we're not just giving you guys some third-rate play that somebody, you know, stuck in Waukegan somewhere. Brooke, no offense to Wisconsin.
Yeah,
sure. Anyway, there's a few celebrities in the audience I'd like to have stand up and take a bow. But I think without having to stand up, would everybody give a hand to the parents and guests and the actors? Here. So I'm going to call the first luminary to just stand up. This guy is a master in many departments, very talented, artistically, scholastically. Is Bulldog Psy here anywhere? Bulldog, are you here? He's not here. Yeah, stand up. Because he prop table right there, so please don't touch. So Austin's here. Let's give it to Oscar so he can take it off.
Oh, is that you, Doug?
Morning, Doc. How you holding up?
Well, I heard you're working cargo today, so so I thought I'd get ready. You know, when there's ever any work to be done, I can expect a big turnout at sick call.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I track a lot of very rare diseases. You know that, Doug. Remember that day when you were loading 5 cargo ships? I was greeted with 6 more cases of beriberi. And, double beriberi. I mean, whatever that is.
What are you giving them these days that are double beriberi?
Aspirin. What else, Doug? Is something the matter, Doug?
No. I've been up all night, Doug.
What is it?
I saw something last night when I was on watch that just about knocked me out.
What was it?
I was up on the bridge, just standing there, looking out to sea. I couldn't bear to look at that island anymore. All of a sudden, I noticed something. Little black specks crawling all over the horizon. I looked through my glasses. It was a formation of our ships that stretched for miles. Carriers, battleships, and cans, a whole task force, Doc.
Why didn't you break me out? I've never seen a battleship before.
They came on and passed in half a mile of that reef. Carriers so big they blacked out after the sky. And battle wagons sliding along, dead quiet. This is what knocked me out, Doc. There were men up on those bridges. I watched them until they're out of sight, Doc. And there were men up on those bridges all the time.
I know how that must have hurt you, Doug.
When I looked down from our bridge and saw our captain's palm tree, our trophy for superior achievement, the Admiral John J. Pinchley Award for delivering more toothpaste and toilet paper than any other Navy cargo ship, they say here in the Pacific. Read this, Doc. See how it sounds.
What is it?
An application for transfer. I've been writing it all night.
Good Lord, not another one, Doug.
No, this one's different. It's got stronger wording. Come on, read it.
All right. From Lieutenant J.G. Douglas Roberts to Bureau of Naval Personnel. Subject, change of duty. Request for, boy, this is sheer poetry, Doug.
Come on, read it.
For 2 years and 7 months, I have served aboard this vessel as cargo officer. I feel that my continued service aboard can only increase disharmony aboard this ship.
How about that?
I therefore urgently request transfer to combat duty. Preferably aboard a destroyer.
That ought to do it, eh, Doc?
Doug, you've been sending letters in every week for who knows how long.
Not like this.
And every time the captain has forwarded your letters disapproved and screamed like a self kid.
That's my point, Doc. He does forward them. They go through the chain of command all the way back to Washington. Just because the captain doesn't.
Doug, the captain of a Navy ship is the only monarch left in this world.
I know that.
If he forwarded your letters approved, you get your orders within a minute. But come on, Doug, disapprove? You haven't got a chance. You're stuck on this old bucket just like the rest of us.
Well, grant me this much, Doc. That one day, I'll get the perfect wording. One human guy will read those words and say, here's a poor son of a bitch screaming for help. Let's put him on a fighting ship.
Sure.
Got a chance, Doc. Got a chance, haven't I?
Yes, Doug. You do have a chance. It's about the same chance as taking a letter, putting it in a bottle, and dropping it straight in the ocean.
Chance, damn it, still a chance.
Still a chance. Well, I better get down to my hypochondriacs. What the hell you did to that task force?
Morning, Mr. Roberts.
Morning, Dowdy.
Gee. It's even hotter up here than it is down in that mess hall. Look at that cruddy island. Smell it. Just like a hog pen. Think we'll get out of here today, sir?
I don't know. There's an LCG guy coming alongside for supplies. The others gotten up yet?
Yeah, they're starting to stumble around there. Poor punch drunk bastards. Mr. Roberts. When we go into the cabin again, ask him to give this crew a liberty.
Dowdy, the last time I asked him was last night.
What'd he say?
He said no.
We gotta get these guys ashore. They're going nuts.
Have Dolan type that up.
Oh, your letter. Yes, sir.
look at something and imagine it. You can see, even if it ain't there.
So?
Well, first you gotta breathe for it.
Breathe?
Good. In and out. Get in the rhythm.
Okay, what?
In and out. In and out. In and out.
What?
Good. Now, you gotta make those noises like those monks from Tibet.
Where?
You know, the Om sound.
Brought you my butter yet?
No, I just got it.
pound of incense in a shoebox?
He's from Shanghai. He's going to break out the dagger off this ship, Resurrection Day.
How could you do it? Hold on. Did the port director say he'd send us you a liberty port?
Hell no. He just said, get out of my sight, Roberts. I'm busy. No Romeo.
Well, when there's a Romeo, there's hope. Let's just pray that he starts in on that stuff so he'll mellow a little bit.
Roberts, you waste the bed.
I don't believe in you anyhow, Frank.
Roberts, come here! Check this out! Look at all these fancy pillows! Somebody's been expecting company!
Oh, good lord!
It says, Toujours l'amour! Souvenir San Diego, ooh la la!
Mine says, compliments of Alicia and May, farm equipment. We plow deep while the other sleeps. Say, Doc, that new hospital hasn't got any new nurses, has it?
Nurses? Oh, sure, so it didn't have any nurses yesterday!
Well, it has today.
How did they get over there?
Let me see. It came to me all of a sudden. I was sitting down here in my pocket. I thought to myself there wasn't a breath of fresh air. So I opened up a window, and then a breeze came in, and I thought to myself, poor boy, there's women on that there island.
Doc, this thing can make bird dogs self-conscious as hell.
18 of them transferred in last night, all brunettes except for two beautiful blonde sisters. I asked one of them to the ship with me, and she said, well, no. So I turned on the old personality, and I said, isn't there anything that will make you come to the ship with me? She said, yes, there is one thing, and one thing only. Incense.
Look, I'm sorry, Frank.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
No, I'm really sorry. It's your first assignment in over a year.
I just thought I would bring her in here and break out some of that incense that my grandmother sent me. She said it would do wonders for any girl that I'm trying to woo. She said that no woman could resist the charms of a man with this particular incense lit. But without it, she wouldn't. She just wouldn't, that's all.
Doc, let's make some incense.
What?
As naval officers, we're supposed to be resourceful. Frank here's got a great opportunity, and I've let him down. Let's pick some right up.
Okay. Yeah, get that bucket there. Come on, guys. Come down here. Yeah. All right, boys. We're going to need base for this here incense. It's right there. Holder, do we have any of the bird seed left that we stole from the captain? Those poor excuses of canaries are too fat anyway.
It's not the right color.
Color. Parsley, have you got any?
I've seen parsley in 4 months. No, I've only 5 months.
I've got it.
Oh, thank God. Right. What shade would you like?
Shade?
White or dark?
How about shadow?
I told her incense.
All right, incense it is. Here, grab the sign right here. I need a hammer.
You said hammer. Got one?
Then get it, man!
Come on, get the man a hammer, will you? This man needs room to work his magic.
Where's the hammer? All right.
Shadow Serpenter.
This looks just like the stuff you can buy right next to the Great Wall of China, Fulmer.
It might look like it, but it sure doesn't want to smell like it.
Say, Doc, what does incense smell like?
I don't know.
It's always smelled like to me.
Right. Drop of corn syrup for taste. All right, we need a glass of water.
Come on, get the man a glass of water. We're waiting on. Close it up.
It's looking good, Doug. All right, stand back, extinguish.
Ever finished anything you start out to do? You sleep 16 hours a day. You've said you want me to improve your mind? You've never finished one book I've given you to read.
I finished God's Little Acre, Doug boy.
You give it that? You've been reading God's Little Acre for over a year.
Classic.
You're the captain of laundry morale, and I doubt if you've even seen the laundry.
I was down there just last week.
And you're scared of the captain.
I am not scared of the captain.
Why the hell do you hide in the passageway every time you see him coming? I doubt if he even knows you're on this ship. You're scared of him.
I'm not scared of the captain. I'm scared of what I might do to the captain.
Listen to this guy. What he might do to him. He bores me silly all day with great moronic plots against the captain, but he's not even carried out one.
I haven't, huh?
Oh, Frank, you haven't. Whatever happened to your plan about clogging the line of the captain's sanitary system? He'll make it overflow, you said. He'll make it overflow so it knocks him off the phone and lifts him clean across the room.
I thought about that yesterday for half an hour.
Half an hour?
Yeah, half an hour.
There's only one thing you've thought about for half an hour in your life. What about the other plan where you gather in marbles so you put them in the captain's overhead and they rock around at night and keep them awake?
Alright, now you've gone too far. What does that look like to you? 5 marbles, and I found another one today. That's 6 marbles. I'm looking for marbles all goddamn day.
Frank, I was going to tell you what I thought of it. Well, I'll tell you. They actually learn to be a man. They actually go up to the captain and knock on his door and put the marbles in the overhead and say, put these marbles there, because they'll actually have some respect for me. That's the day when I will look up to you as a man, okay?
Okay.
Intersecting 30 miles north of Hanover, the rupture and collapse brought forth the remark from a high London official that the end of the war in Europe is only weeks away, maybe days.
Who the hell's going with my letter? I'm gonna find him.
Doug, I wouldn't send in that letter if I were you.
What do you mean, that letter?
I mean any of the letters you've been writing. What are you so nervous about anyway?
Nervous?
Ha! About getting off the ship. We're a threesome, aren't we? You, me, and Doc. Share and share alike. You didn't think I was going to keep my nurse to myself, did you? No. As soon as I get mine under control, I'm going to start for a sister, just for you.
Damn decent of you, Frank.
And then I'm going to work up something for you too, Doc. And in the meantime, you've got a lot of work to do. Watching my grammar and making sure I don't ever say anything like disharmony aboard this. I mean, if I ever said anything like harmony aboard this.
What's the big idea?
I just wanted to talk to you before you sent it in. You can't send it in that way, it's too strong. You're just running a race with death. It's stupid to keep asking for it like that, and Doc says so too. Tell him, Doc.
Doc, are you going to tell me my case?
Yes, I would, Doc. You know, last night when I was speaking with you, you said that you only felt half alive, not fighting in this war, and being out here delivering cargo. Well, Doug, I thought that over, and I think that's just a crockful, Doug, just a crockful.
I take it back, Doc. You've seen that task force, I don't feel that much alive.
You're stupid, Doug. Hey, come on, I can prove it too. You quit medical school when you could be saving lives today. Why? Do you even know yourself?
Doc, has it ever occurred to you that guys who fight this war might also be saving lives? Yours and mine, for instance.
Whether you like it or not, that's exactly what we're doing. The sorrow bucket, it does a necessary job, Doug.
The sorrow bucket does a necessary job.
And guess what? You're the man who keeps his crew working cargo. But more importantly, you keep these men alive, Doug. It's all about you. It may just be that right here, you're deeper and more truly in this war than you will be anywhere else.
Jeez, Doc, you made us start quoting Emerson.
Okay, that is a lousy thing to say.
We've got nothing to do with the war. Maybe that's why we're on this ship, because we're not good enough to fight. Maybe there's some omniscient son of a bitch that goes down the line of all the service, picks out the ones to send to combat. The ones whose glands scream out the drill, whose great-great-grandfathers were afraid of the dark or something. The rest of us are shoved off to ships like this where we can't do any harm.
Doug, what is it, you want to be a hero or something?
Doc, the war's way out there. I'm here. I don't want to be here. I want to be out there. I've got to feel like I'm better than a lousy spectator. I've got to feel like I'm good enough to be in this thing, to participate.
Good enough? Doug, you're good enough. You just don't have the chance. That's basically what physical heroism is, too. It's opportunity. Hell, it's a reflex. I would say 75 out of 100 young men, they have that reflex. If you took any one of them, say, gun, Frank got some pulver here. Do you know what you would have, Doug? You'd have Pulver, the Congressional Medal of Honor winner. Pulver, who single-handedly shot down 23 attacking Japanese planes. Pulver, who with his bare hands held together the severed wing parts of his plane and landed on his home base. Help, Doug, it's a reflex. It's just like the knee jerk. You strike the patella tendon, and then you burst it, and you produce a knee jerk. Like, look.
What's wrong?
Nothing, Frank. But stay out of B-29, my boy.
You made your point very vividly, Doc. Yeah, but I'm figuring to get into this thing. I've been sending letters until I do. I don't have much time. That task force started the last big push against the Japanese. It went by me, Doc. I plan to check it.
Okay, Lieutenant, we're loaded. Start the winch.
Okay, start the winch, hey.
Schlutter, look out.
Let her in easy.
Mr. Walters, the captain says to not give the LCD any fresh food. He says he's going to keep it for his own mess.
Okay.
Oh, hold your hat, Mr. Walters. I just saw going over there.
Here's what the LCD guy wants.
1 ton dry stores, quarter ton frozen food. 1 gross dumplings. Okay, we can give him all that.
Hey, can these guys take off their shirts while we're working?
How do you know the captain's a standing?
One guy just passed out from the heat.
All right, take your shirts off. LCT, want to swap movies? We got a new one.
What's that?
Luke Gibson and Riders of the Range.
No thanks, we saw that 3 times already.
All set, Mr. Roberts.
Hey, Lieutenant, one thing I did put on my list because I wanted to ask you, you couldn't spare us any fresh fruit, could you?
You all out?
We haven't seen any for 3 months.
Dowdy.
Yes, sir.
Give the LCT guy a couple of crates of oranges.
Yes, sir.
Compliments of the captain.
Aye, sir.
Okay, here comes your first sling load. Watch that line.
Slack off, you dumb bastard. Slack off. Mr. Roberts!
What is it?
The captain wants to see you immediately.
Damn it! There it goes! Part of the lot!
Get a fender over, quick! You go tell the captain I'm busy. All right, watch his bow. He's coming in fast.
Hands up!
Let's secure somewhere. Take it around the bend.
Around the bend?
Not too much. Cut him some slack this time. Okay, that's good. Secure.
All secure.
All right, give him the rest of his cargo.
Batman!
All right, mister, let's have this out right here now. What do you mean by telling me you're too busy to see me?
We parted the line, Captain. You didn't want me to leave the deck with
you. Damn right, I want you to leave the deck, Mr. Roberts. When I tell you I want to see you, I expect you to jump. Do you understand me?
Yes, sir. I'll try to remember that next
time. Damn right you'll remember. Damn right. Don't ever tell me you're too busy to see me again. What do you mean by writing this letter, Mr. Roberts? Trying to get me in bad with the Admiral, ain't you? Well, ain't you?
No, I'm not, sir.
Well, then, what do you mean by writing disharmony aboard this ship?
Oh, because it's true, sir.
Any disharmony aboard this ship is my own doing.
Oh, that's also true, sir.
Damn right. I ain't gonna leave any ship that I command. Now, I have a good reputation with the Admiral, and I ain't gonna lose it on account of some smart out of college officer like yourself. If you go back and you retype this and you leave out that disharmony crap, maybe I'll send it in. But this is the last one, you understand me?
in a request for transfer, and no one can change the wording.
Is that so? Don't.
That's what it says, sir.
So, I hate the Navy, you know that. And it's never dealt with this kind of crap when I was in the merchant service. All right, give me a letter. I'll send it in just to prove like I always do. But there's one thing I don't have to do, Mr. Roberts, and that's sending a letter that ain't been written. And, mister, I'm telling you right here and now, if I find another letter on my desk, you're going to regret it if it's not understood.
Yes,
sir. All of you, you're dismissed. Wait, where are your shirts? Get those shirts on in a damn quick hurry. Shut up, Roberts. I've given you an order. Put those shirts on now.
All right, men. Get your shirts on.
So you're going to listen to him and not to me. You know, that's the rankest piece of insubordination I've ever seen. You know, you're all pretty cute playing grab-ass with Roberts here, but one thing I want to let you know, I ain't going to forget it. I ain't going to forget anything you guys have been doing. You know what? I just have a better idea. Why not put every single one of you men on report who disobeyed my order?
Captain, you are not putting these men on report.
Why not, Mr. Roberts? I'm the captain here. I can do whatever I want.
I'm responsible. I give them permission.
Mr. Roberts, I don't give a damn if five men pass out. I don't give a damn if the whole crew passes out. When I give an order, I expect it to be followed. Is that understood?
I believe so, sir.
Now, get your shirts on and get out of my sight.
Thanks a million for the oranges, Lieutenant.
Give that LCT fresh fruit.
Yes, sir, we did, sir.
Mr. Roberts died, Matt. The last straw from you, Mr. Roberts. You've been sending yourself 10 days in your room, mister. 10 days.
Very well. Do you need to be here?
You're damn right. I want you to go to your room right now, and I'll tell you when you need to be there. God damn it, there's no one here to work the ship. Mr. Roberts, get back out of here. I'll tell you when you have 10 days in your room, and you don't damn well know it. Is that understood?
Yes,
good,
sir.
Now get those men back out. I need somebody out here working this damn ship. Now, wait, who are you? Yes, you're front and center. By Robbie Lee's beard, you won my office, aren't you?
Yes, sir.
What's your name?
Ensign Pulver, sir.
Pulver. Mr. Pulver, that's right. How come I don't see you around, Mr. Pulver?
I've wondered about that myself, sir.
What do you do?
Officer in charge of laundry and
well, office. You're the one who put your starch in my underwear, don't you?
Yes, sir.
Good, I like it that way. Oh, well, how long have you been aboard this vessel?
14 months, sir.
14 months, by the dictionary show. How come I don't see you around, Mr. Pulver?
I've often wondered about that, too.
Me, too. Well, you know, Mr. Pulver, I like you. You're an officer who knows how to salute. I'd like to see more of you. Why don't you show me how the laundry works? I've always been fascinated with machines.
Today, sir?
Yes, right now.
I can't today, sir.
Why not?
I have to head over to the island. There's a piece of medical equipment I
really?
Well, Frank, I'll take care of that for you.
That's right, Mr. Pulver. Excuse me, Mr. Roberts. Why don't you be useful? How about it, Mr. Pulver?
This is something I wouldn't want anyone else doing for me, sir.
All right, Mr. Pulver, I understand. But remember, I'd like to see more of you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Oh, boy, I'd like to see more of you, Pulver. That blind old son of a bitch. Acting like he doesn't know me.
Hey, nice going, Mr. Roberts.
Man, it was beautiful the way you read the old man off.
Hey, Mr. Roberts, wanted to ask you, can I take another letter?
I'm afraid the pump's that job, don't.
Yeah, you heard him.
Oh, come on, Mr. Roberts, can I?
Nope. What are we waiting for, guys? Let's give the man the rest of his cargo.
Change that.
is it coming from?
I told you, there's a big great canoe with little old fat women in them playing little old guitars.
When are we gonna go up on the deck?
Well, forget about the one on deck. Where are we gonna go ashore?
Oh man, you shall see this.
Wait, let me see the.
Hey, how about some other time? All right.
Hey Sam, here's another penny. Make the mannequins out there die for it.
All right. Hey, Johnny, where'd you say those women hang out?
For the last time. You see that hill over there?
Yeah.
See the church?
Yeah.
Past the church.
Yeah, I'm past the church.
That's the park.
Well, yeah.
They're all women over there. All right, line up, and I'll show you where the women hang out.
Downey, his mother, shoe polish? These guys have gone nuts.
Yeah, I went down to the ship store the other day to buy some. And you know, they've been sold out for over a week. No soap, no Listerine, no mum, nothing.
What's the word on Liberty?
Oh, the old man's still asleep.
Hey, I'll go to his bunk and wake him up.
Like hell you are. You're gonna stay right here and pray. You're gonna pray that he wakes up feeling good and keeps you boys sweating long enough.
Hey man, that sounds real asshole. Good job.
Yeah, good idea. Now we hear this! Now we hear this!
Here we go, Liberty!
Hey, what? Hey, what? Shut up!
Now we hear this! The captain's messenger reports to the captain's cabin on the double!
He's awake!
It won't be long now! Come on, oh my god, I'm so excited! I need to sing! Well, nah, 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 nah!
This is the captain speaking. Now, it has come to my personal attention that men here are expecting Liberty. Well, I don't know how such a rumor got around, but I'm here to clear it up. There will be no Liberty as long as we're here in this port due to cargo restrictions and security conditions. Now, no man is to wear flight uniforms as long as we're here in this port. Is that understood? This is the captain speaking. Once again, no Liberty.
Damn it!
Of the captain. Now this port director was kind enough to send us our orders, along with a little thank you note. Sir Roberts, I'll admit I was a little provoked about not being consulted, but then I got to thinking, well maybe this is a good thing, maybe by some stroke of luck. Coming here was not such a bad idea. But why, Mr. Roberts? Well, since you and I could have a little talk.
Let's quit wasting time.
Sir Roberts, I have two things I want to show you. First is his hat. Now this is the captain with full commander. Can you see it? The captain with full commander. Now I'm gonna wear that cap one day, Mr. Roberts, and you're going to help me. I suppose there's no trouble in telling you that you helped me get that palm tree right on the deck over there from our good Admiral Finchley. Now when Mr. Finchley awarded me that palm tree, he said, Morton, you have a fine cargo officer, you keep him at it. So I went out and bought this hat. Now don't let it get to your head, Mr. Roberts. You've helped me a lot through my career. But there's one thing I don't like about you, Mr. Roberts. You can't listen to orders. Now, I told you last week I didn't want any letters on my desk. What do I find this time? Another one. This time reading friction between myself and my commanding officer. Can you read that, sir?
Yes,
What does it say in bold?
Friction between myself and my commanding
officer. Friction between myself and my commanding officer. That is not going to cut it, Mr. Roberts.
Are you going to stop it, Captain?
Oh, I'm not, Mr. Roberts. How much do you want this crew to get a liberty anyhow? Enough to stop writing letters, enough to stop disobeying my orders, because that's the only way this crew is going to get ashore, Mr. Roberts, I guarantee you. Well, we've had our little talk, Mr. Roberts. I'm in the mood for some good news right now. What do you say?
How did you join the Navy? How'd you join our side?
I believe I was drafted,
Mr.
Roberts.
What I joined up to fight against! You ignorant, arrogant son of a bitch!
Careful, Mr. Roberts. You are treading fine water here.
You keep 167 men in prison because they got a palm tree.
Mr. Roberts, I will remind you that I'm your commanding officer and I will not stand.
I don't know what I hate more. You or that malignant growth that stands outside
your door. Mr.
Roberts, you're
going to send yourself a court martial. I hope you like it.
I'm asking for
it. Oh, you don't have to ask, Mr. Roberts. You've got it.
If I can't get transferred off the ship, we'll be court martial up. I'm fed up. But you'll need a witness.
I have a witness. I have God himself.
That's not a witness. Come on, call in Dolan. I'll repeat everything I said in front of him. Come on, call him in.
No, I don't want to do that, Mr. Roberts. You know, Mr. Roberts, I don't give you enough credit sometimes. You're a very smart boy, you know that? I may not talk so good, but you're a very smart boy. But I know how to take care of men like you, Mr. Roberts. Let me tell you something. I hate you. I can't stand your guts. Everything about you makes you sick. You want to know why, Mr. Roberts? Because you think you're better than I am. You think you're better than I am because you've got everything handed to you. I've worked my entire life. I've worked since I was a boy in Louisiana. I served in the restaurant business. I first started as a busboy. They would order me around, men like Mr. Roberts. They would say, "Busboy, clean up the table my friend has just thrown up." When I first went to sea as a steward, they'd order me around there too. "Steward, take my magazine out to the desk chair. Steward, I can't stand the way you look. Please stay out of my sight." Well, I took all that crap, Mr. Roberts. I took it from pimple-faced bastards who weren't even good enough to wipe my nose. Well, last time I checked, Mr. Roberts, there's a war going on, and I'm the captain of this vessel. Now, I cannot do anything to you, Mr. Roberts. As much as I'd like to inflict any kind of pain on you, that is illegal. But the only thing I can do to you, Mr. Roberts, is I can keep you on this ship, and that is exactly where you're going to stay. Have to get out of my office.
Can you hear that music, guys?
Yes, I hear it, Mr. Roberts. I'm not deaf.
Did you know it's tearing those guys apart? What do you want from Logan?
I want plenty, Mr. Roberts. I want plenty. You're through writing letters. Not understood.
Is that all?
You're through talking back to me in front of the crew. You're not even going to open your mouth except in civil answer.
Yes, sir.
Good. One more thing. Does anybody else know you're in here?
No.
Good, because I don't want you talking about this to anybody. It might not sound so good. And plus, I don't want you getting the credit where it's not due.
You think I'm doing this for credit?
I have to be sure, Mr. Roberts.
Well, you got my word, that's all.
Your word. Your college people make a big show about your word.
How about it, Captain? Is it the deal? Right here.
We have a deal, Mr. Roberts. This is the Captain speaking. I have something further to comment on our stay here in Elysium Island. Liberty for the entire starboard
For the entire crew, every single one of them.
Liberty for the entire crew will commence immediately. Roberts, know that if you defy my orders, I will make this a living hell for you and everyone on this ship. Is that understood?
Understood,
not the way these seven gentlemen act, but it happens. Now, I want to know what you're going to do about this, Mr. Rados.
I want you to get relieved for about 15 minutes. I'd be glad to leave
the Army is taking care of that, Mr. Rados. I want to know what punishment we're going to be giving these men.
Sure, I'll think of something, sir.
Yes, count on it, Mr. Rados. I'm not going to leave my cabin until I think of the proper punishment.
Pipe down!
is sick with us. He has put a blot on my record, but we're going to work even harder than we've ever worked before to remove it. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Good. Well, I don't care if we have to work 25 hours in the day, because we're going to make a new hour based on how hard we're going to work. Is that understood? And Mr. Roberts, you are in charge of the men here. You're going to make sure they toe the line. I want these men to work up a sweat. Is that understood?
Absolutely,
this sir. Man is a man who can keep his word. He is honorable, and he's also a college officer. Isn't that right, Mr. Roberts?
Yes,
and
sir.
If you do your job well, Mr. Roberts, maybe the Admiral will begin to shine on us again. You'll get a promotion. How would you like that? Get us ready to move, soldier.
Yes, sir.
Now, I want you, and I want you to scrub the gangplank, and I want you to make sure all the rust is removed. Is that understood? You keep them on it. Isn't that right, Mr. Roberts? That's right, Mr. Roberts.
Yes, sir.
Fantastic. This man is ready to roll.
Mr. Roberts, what do you think he meant?
I don't know, just what he said, I guess.
Hey, why'd you let him give you all that guff for?
Because he's tired, that's why. He had the mid-watch last night. Your tail would be dragging too if you had to handle all them customers.
Right, guys, let's get going.
Wait a minute, Mr. Roberts. Something happened. A little love letter from the Bureau. Get a load of this. To all ships and stations, heightened war offensive has created urgent need of more combat ships for experienced officers. All commanding officers are hereby directed to forward with their endorsements all applications for transfer for officers with 24 months sea duty. You got 29 months, Mr. Roberts. You're the only officer aboard that has. The captain is hanging on the ropes for the working over the Admiral game. All he needs to find him is one more little jab. Here it is. Your letter. I typed it up. Sign it and I'll take it in.
Come on, Mr. Roberts, sign it.
I want to look this thing over first, though. Come on, let's get going.
What? There's nothing to look over. This is the same letter of yesterday. I'm quoting the new director.
Roman, I'm tired. I told you I would.
You're not too tired. Come on,
Mr. Roberts.
Right, take it easy. Don't let knock it inside it, okay?
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm pissed off. Let's get out of here.
What the hell has come over him?
Yeah, go do that.
Please transfer me, will you? Bring me ashore on this next island. You can do it. You don't need the captain's permission. I see there's something wrong with my eyes or my feet or my head. You can drum something up.
What good would that do?
Plenty. I could lie around the hospital for a couple of days. By that time, the ship would have sailed out of this time. I'd be finally off this ship. Can you do it, Doc?
Why did you just put Dolan on the port, Doug?
I gave him an order. He didn't carry it out fast enough to suit me.
Come on, Doug. You know that's BS. Tell me the truth. What is it?
It's not true. It was the war. It was ending. I had just heard the news, and there was Dolan giving me guff about something. And all of a sudden, I hated him. I hated all of them. I hated those sullen-faced bastards looking at me like I sold them down the river or something. And they think I'm bucking for a promotion. They think I'd walk 10 feet across the room to get anything from that captain. And I think I'd prove this whole damn ungrateful mob.
Doug, do you think this crew owes you something?
What the hell do you mean by that?
You talk as if they did. Listen to yourself.
That's right. I didn't realize it, but that's exactly the way I've been feeling. I'm taking something out of them. I'm blaming them for...
For what? Doug, you made some sort of agreement with the captain. Come on, tell me, what is it? I'm your friend.
Agreement? I don't know what you're talking about. Will you please transfer me?
Oh, come on, Doug. You know I can't transfer you. I'll never get away with that.
Guys, turn up the radio. Come back and listen to me.
This broadcast should bring you a special news flash. Apparently, the war is over in Europe. The war is over in Rheims. Germany has surrendered unconditionally to the Allied armies. The surrender is signed in the schoolhouse in the city of Rheims.
This is great! May I still remind you, though, there is a minor skirmish in the Pacific, Doug.
You could have missed that one, too. But tell with me, this is the greatest day in all the world. I'm going to celebrate. Ain't that right, friend?
Of course, we've got to celebrate.
What will it be, boys? Alcohol and orange juice? Or,
orange juice and alcohol?
That's not good enough.
Hell no, Doc.
We gotta take something else. Lift this ship right out of the water and turn it the other way. I've got it, guys. I've got it. It's the best idea in the whole world. It's the only thing we can do. Doug, you said I never started anything I finished, but tonight, you're wrong. I was gonna say this for your birthday, but we gotta celebrate. We just have to.
Wait, Frank, what is it?
A firecracker, damn it. We'll take it, and we'll throw it under the captain's bunk. Bam, bam, bam! Wake up, you old son of a bitch! It's BE Day! God,
get on that ship. He wants to fight, feel alive. He's not gonna get to it. It's a shame.
We ruined our celebration, Doc. I let down Logan.
It's okay.
We hope that the king and queen will come up. The crowds are cheering. Listen to them. And at any second now, we hope to see their majesties. The color here is tremendous. Everywhere rosettes. Everywhere jubilous. Red, white, and blue hats. All the girls in their summer frocks in this lovely round historic May evening. And although we celebrate with joy as part of the great victory, perhaps the greatest victory in the history of mankind, the underlying mood is the mood of Thanksgiving. And now I believe they're coming. They haven't breathed. They haven't appeared. But the crowd of the Senate are cheering madly. Handkerchiefs, flags, hands waving. Here they come. First, her majesty, the queen is coming to view. The king of the uniform and admiral of the fleet, the two princesses standing in the balcony. Listen to the crowd!
Well, see if I bust in the laundry room. Get the coin up now. Guess where it's going to see.
Well, that jammer on the radio,
bro. That's what I know. King, queen.
Like I was saying, that admiral on easy mind, he was a killer, wasn't he?
Yeah, I remember this sergeant. That sergeant must have grown 6 inches since we left the Elysium. Well, anyway, I remember those old days when I went down that bay and I wiped all that shit from home and then. I remember the sergeant. He said I was the best man he ever had.
Hey, come on, Joel. Follow to a guy.
Toss this thing overboard! Ah! General quarters! Order of attack! Go, go, go!
Roberts! You gave me a word!
I did.
What? What is the meaning of this?
I don't know. You tell me.
Roberts! You gave me a word you would stop disrespecting me in front of the crew.
I didn't know.
Explain yourself, Roberts. We had a deal. I would do what you want. I'd give this crew liberty. You would stop.
I did.
Roberts!
I didn't do
anything. Admit it. I want to see if you have the courage to admit your guilt. Admit it.
What can I?
Roberts, I...
Captain, you all right? We need a medic! Get a medic!
What? Shape or form, you're necessary
orders. Yourself, praying, fasting, sending in enough weed box tops.
What Dolan said when my old letters turned up.
Doug, that's bat crap. This crew got you transferred.
What do you mean? They signed the captain's name?
No. Here's what happened. Well, they were too busy thinking about themselves like you always say they were. They were willing to land themselves in prison for 5 years to do something for you. Guess what? You didn't want to send a letter, so they did it for you. And guess what? The captain wasn't going to sign any letter that you sent to him approved, so they didn't bother. They did it for you.
Who did it? Which one of them?
It's hard to say, Doug. Hey, let me tell you about the little contest we had last night. Everyone met in compartments yesterday. There was guards at every door, so we didn't want anyone to know what was happening. 167 men showed up, ready to sign their name. They were all giving blank pieces of paper, and they wanted to see which signature best resembled the captain's. There was a little fight because, you know, some of the judges were a little drunk, but we got that figured out later. I'm a double honor of being a contestant and a judge. You see, I think it's because of my character, charm, good looks, and because the medical department donated 4 gallons of grain alcohol to anyone who participated.
Wish you hadn't told me that.
So
pretty stupid about what I just said, but I didn't mean it. I love those guys. Some of the greatest guys on this earth. Wrong about believing that. What should I say?
You shouldn't say anything. You don't even know. Doug, just remember, 167 guys came down to do something for good old Mr. Roberts. Hey, you get on your new shiny old bucket, I'm supposed to write you a letter saying, hey, Mr. Roberts, thanks for everything, especially thanks for the liberty.
Good Lord. Guys, guess what? The captain just made me the new cargo officer. And that's not all. He likes me. He wants to have dinner with me tonight. Come on in.
Kick some ass, Mr. Roberts!
Kick them Japs' ass!
part is for Doc. I've been aboard this destroyer for 2 weeks now, and we've already been through 4 air attacks. I'm in the war at last, Doc. I've caught up with that task force that passed me by. I'm glad to be here. I had to be here, I guess. But I'm thinking now of you, Doc, and of you, Frank, and Dolan, and Dowdy, and Insignia, and everybody else on that bucket. All the guys everywhere who sail from tedium to apathy and back again with occasional side trips to monotony. This is a tough crew on here, and they have a wonderful battle here. But I've discovered, Doc, that the most terrible enemy in this war is the boredom that eventually becomes a fate, and therefore a sort of suicide. And I know now that the ones who refuse to surrender to it must be very strong. Right now, I'm looking at something that's hanging over my desk, a preposterous hunk of brass attached to the most ilious piece of ribbon I've ever seen. I'd rather have it than the Congressional Medal of Honor. It tells me that when I always be proud of, that at a time when courage counted the most, I lived among 167 brave men. So Doc, and especially you, Frank, don't let those guys down. Of course, I know by this time, they must be very happy because the captain's over it, so with marbles. Oh, hell, here comes the mail order. This has to go now. I'll finish it later. Meanwhile, you bastards can write too, can't you? Doug.
Can I see that letter?
This next one's from Cornell.
Rather have it. Congressional Medal of Honor. Glad he found that out.
All done, Mr. Colbert.
Frank, what is it? Who's up front? Frank, what does the letter say?
Hey, Frank.
Mr. Roberts is dead. The Livingston took a Japanese suicide plane. Took out half the ship. We're drinking coffee when it hit.
Mr. Bulwer, may I please take that letter to the crew?
No. Take this one. This belongs to them.
Coffee?
Come on, Daniel. I'll stay up watch for you.
Sure.
You mean I have to deal with another one?